sites as being tourist attractions mean that they are valuable sources of revenue. With this concern in mind, our campaign wishes to bring their legacy back to life. As being tour guides, we play a key role in the archaeological site tourist experience by providing interpretation and information. So we are launching an enriching campaign covering all of Egypt's archaeological sites.
Easy Guide, a wide-ranging social media campaign that contributed to Egypt's tourist industry, that carried out by tourism guidance students of both MUST University of Science and Technology and Helwan University, using a lot of social media platforms like YouTube, Facebook and Instagram in order to draw people's attention in Egypt and also to increase their interest in Egypt and to say, hey, come to Egypt.
The word Egypt, the first thing that you think about is the pyramids of Giza, the Sphinx, the Temple of Hatshepsut and Luxor and Karnak. But little who thinks about the Islamic monuments and its architecture that fills each corner of Egypt, and especially Cairo. So we're here to show you and introduce to you the amazing marks that have been left by our Islamic leaders. We're here to show you the archaeological greatness and mesmerizing beautiful monuments did not end with the ancient Egyptians, but continued till the Islamic period and beyond.
In our campaign, we're going to discuss the forms of Islamic architecture here in Egypt, starting by the mosque, which is the holy place where we're praying for Muslims people. Also, the Zawiya, it's the same as mosque, but smaller in size. We have a Sabil, which is a charity, for it's like equivalent to a dispenser, free work, instead of finding inside a building or in the street. It's always attached to a kutab, which is a place for teaching children the holy book of Quran. Also, the madrasa is a school for teaching the four sectors of Islam. Movement of Sufis and their places. We have Konkos, which is a Persian word. Also later on in Turkish period we have Tikiyas. So we're gonna discuss the places of Konkos and Tikiyas.
In our campaign we will cover Cairo's Islamic district, starting with Al-Fustat, the first Islamic capital, that's standing as a religious complex center. We have in it the first mosque built in both Egypt and Africa, the oldest synagogue and the oldest church in Egypt. In Gamaleya district, we have Al-Azhar Mosque at the first Islamic university for the Shia sect, Al-Hussein and Al-Hakim mosques. In the Darb al-Ahmar district, we visit the Blue Mosque and White Sheikh Mosque and Abu Khaybah Mosque. As for the Khalifa district, we visit Ibn Tulun Mosque and Saladin Square, including their monuments, Rifa'i and Sultan Hassan Mosques. District, we will cover the monuments of their burial as we cover the monuments of their worship. As we have the complex of Qaid Bay, the complex of Al-Ashraf Horse Bay, and the complex of Farag ibn Balq.
Divided into topics. These topics will be handled by episodes highlighting the interesting monuments and telling the story of their history. After watching these episodes, you'll be able to find out a monument's founder, the date of its construction, and the details and interesting details about this monument, as well as the nearby monuments. The problems facing these monuments, and later on communicated with the government, and solutions are being undertaken right this second. We wrote our own comprehensive researches about them. Later on, we are applying this research onto a YouTube channel.
Sadly, we had to put our plans on hold due to these circumstances which we live in, this pandemic, coronavirus, which has afflicted our nation and humanity as a whole, and for the safety and well-being of our fellow Egyptians and our country, we stayed at home. Although our mission is momentous and its gain is clear, it's our country that benefits from it, but now what will most benefit our country is following the safety instructions and avoiding gatherings and staying at home. And practice social distancing. Our country's welfare is our topmost priority. Our efforts will certainly make a difference in our country's fight and efforts against the coronavirus. We are certain that this situation will improve and soon pass. And we assure you, we will return with our posts and videos.
This is just an intermission. Stay home, stay safe, and we will see you soon.